Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I will introduce a horror film called Hannibal Rising. In 1944, Hannibal is 8 years old living in Lecter Castle, which was constructed by his paternal ancestor. The German invasion of the Soviet Union turns the Baltic region into part of the bloodiest front line of World War II. His younger sister, Misha, and his parents escape to the family's hunting lodge in the woods to elude the advancing German troops. After 3 years, the Nazis are finally driven out of the country, soon to be reoccupied by the Soviet Union. During their retreat, however, they destroy a Soviet tank that had stopped at the Lecter family's lodge looking for water. The explosion kills everyone but Hannibal and Misha. Seeing their wounded SS commander, Grutas shoots him and takes his Iron Cross. However, the impending Russian advance forces them to hide out in the woods where they locate the Lecter lodge. The SS militiamen storm and take over the lodge, finding no other food in the bitterly cold Baltic winter. The men look menacingly at Hannibal and Misha. The movie then cuts to a scene 8 years later inside Lecter Castle, which has been turned into a Soviet-run orphanage. A bully harasses Hannibal, who has been rendered mute by his experiences, about not singing the orphanage anthem. The bully attacks his head, but Hannibal blocks his swing with a fork, impaling the bully's hand. That evening, Hannibal experiences a flashback about Misha screaming in his sleep, which angers the youth commander, who locks him in a dungeon. However, Hannibal escapes from the castle orphanage to Paris to live with his widowed aunt, the Lady Murasaki Lecter. She takes care and brings him up. She gets him to speak for the first time since his childhood, and instructs him about flower arrangement, martial arts, and ancestor worship. Hannibal flourishes as a student in there. At a local market, a butcher makes a crude and racist remark about Lady Murasaki. Hannibal then attacks him. It was until the police came that he would stop, but Hannibal didn't let it go so easily. When he got home, he thought of a way to get revenge on that man. Later, while the butcher is fishing, Hannibal requests an apology from him and is denied. He then slices the butcher's stomach, arm, and back with a katana, then decapitates him. Later that evening, the family cook tells Hannibal that the most delicious part of the fish he took from the butcher is the cheeks, and this helps develop Hannibal's signature style of biting his victim's cheeks. That same evening, he is suspected of the butcher's murder by a French detective who had also lost his family to the war, thanks in great part to the intervention of his aunt, who places the butcher's disembodied head outside police headquarters. While Hannibal is being interrogated inside, Hannibal escapes responsibility for the crime. Eventually, Hannibal becomes the youngest person ever admitted to medical school in France. He receives a working scholarship, where he is given a job preparing cadavers. Hannibal witnesses a condemned war criminal receiving a sodium thiopental injection, allowing him to recall details about his crimes. Consequently, in an attempt to recall the names of those responsible for his sister's death, Hannibal injects himself with the solution. His subsequent flashback reveals the men who had killed Misha had cannibalized her as well. The dog tags should still be in the ruins of the lodge. Hannibal returns to Lithuania in search of the dog tags as well as his sister's remains. While crossing the Soviet border, he draws the attention of Dortlich, who is now a Soviet border patrol officer. Hannibal excavates the ruins of the lodge and also unearths the dog tags of the group of deserters who had killed his sister. Dortlich attempts to kill him, but Hannibal gets the upper hand and incapacitates him. Dortlich refuses to reveal the rest of his gang. Hannibal kills him. His blood splashes on Hannibal's face and he wipes it off and licks it. Hannibal went back to Paris after getting a clue. His aunt missed him so much. Hannibal told Lady Murasaki that he had found out the man who killed his sister. Hannibal then visits the restaurant of another one of the soldiers, Petra's Kolna's in Fontainebleau. He finds Kolna's young daughter, whom he notices is wearing Misha's bracelet. He then gives Kolna's dog tag to her. Kolna enters the restaurant, but Lady Murasaki persuades Hannibal not to kill him for the sake of Kolna's children. Dortlich's murder puts the rest of the group on alert, and, because of the similarity to the first murder, Grutas, a sex trafficker, dispatches a second member of the group, Zygmas Milkoat, to kill Hannibal. Hannibal now is under renewed suspicion from Detective Popple. He comes to Hannibal's room and finds some portraits of the victim. Milko sneaks into Hannibal's laboratory at night with a gun, but Hannibal senses his presence and knocks him out with an injection. Hannibal locks Milko in the cadaver tank, kills Milko by drowning him in embalming chemicals inside his laboratory. Hannibal then left the laboratory. Popple questions Hannibal about Dortlich's murder, but is again unable to establish Hannibal's guilt. During a confrontation with Lady Murasaki, she begs him not to get revenge. He refuses, claiming that he made a promise to Misha. Hannibal then sets up a time bomb in Grutas' home and attacks him in the bath. However, a maid alerts Gruta's bodyguards, who then rush in. Just as Gruta's bodyguards are about to slit his throat, Hannibal's time bomb goes off and he escapes. Hannibal comes back home and finds his aunt missing. Gruta kidnaps Lady Murasaki and calls Hannibal, using her as bait. Hannibal recognizes the sounds of Colna's ortolans from his restaurant in the background. Hannibal goes there and plays on Colna's emotions by threatening his children, forcing him to give up the location of Gruta's boat. Hannibal then says he will leave Colna's alone for the sake of his family, and places his gun on the hot stove. As Colna's goes for the gun, Hannibal impales him through the head with his tent. He then hides the tent behind his back. Hannibal goes to the houseboat. Just as he is about to untie Lady Murasaki, Gruta shoots him in the back. Gruta then proceeds to molest Lady Murasaki. Hannibal takes out the tent, which was broken by the force of the bullet, and slashes Gruta's Achilles tendon with it, crippling him. In a final confrontation, Gruta claims that Hannibal too had consumed his sister in broth fed to him by the deserters. Enraged by the revelation, Hannibal eviscerates Gruta's by repeatedly carving his sister's initial into his body. Hannibal bites off Gruta's cheeks in what will become his signature attack. The houseboat is then incinerated, but Hannibal, assumed to be dead, emerges from the woods. The film then concludes with Hannibal hunting down the last member of the group Grunts in Canada. Hannibal, after killing him, moves to America, thus beginning his killings in the country.